right. Good morning, everybody. How are we doing? Let's stand up. We're going to sing our first song, Jesus Does. Ready?
Please be seated. It's great to see you on this beautiful Sunday morning. It's not as hot as last week was, but it's good to be together. A few things I want to share with you that you know what is happening. So we had an awesome cruise night this week, and there's going to be another cruise night coming up on July 10th. And so we invite you to be outside, listen to music, have good food and great fun. So please join us. If you're in need of a grief share support group, we meet another time this week on Tuesday in the youth room at 6:30, so please join us for our grief share group or invite a friend who you know who is struggling. And we are super excited about our first annual 5K run. Some of you already registered, so please take a moment and go to our church website and register and support our food pantry. And I heard there is a shark in the water. I don't know if you saw that, so be careful. I mean it. There is a shark around. Uh-oh. Take a look. Here you are. So we have a special shark announcement. Let's see what happens. Hope he's not going to bite us. Woo! Here's the shark. Woo hoo hoo.
Luckily, she's a very nice shark. She's going to be at VBS this year. It's a scuba-themed. A vacation Bible school is going to take place Tuesday, July 16th through Friday, July 19th. We're going to dive a little deeper into our friendship with God, have fun, get to know each other, play games, do crafts. It's going to be a wonderful, fun week, and we hope all age 3 through starting 6th grade are welcome to come, and if you're older than that, you're welcome to come and still lead a group, help with anything. We also could use some adults to come lead the little ones in their journey with God. So thank you.
Woohoo! All right. That's a fun way to start. All right, let us pray together. Almighty God, we thank you that you love and care for all your people. When storm clouds loom and troubles threaten, bring peace and calm to us, because we know that everything is in your hands. We ask this through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Let's stand. Let's sing Ancient of Days. Put your hands together.
Grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Now let's greet one another as we share God's peace. Boys and girls, you can come forward now for your kids' time. Sunny is here from Florida.
Oh, yes, I'm here from Florida. Hi, guys, come here. Why don't you meet right here? Yes. Oh, my glasses.
Yes, I'm so glad you came.
Yes, Florida is very hot. We had so much rain, so I thought I'd come up. It's nice and cool, and I was invited to go to a canoe trip. Ooh, I'm so excited, but I'm also a little scared. Hi, I don't know if you ever had been in a canoe, so I'm not such a good swimmer. I'm a doggy, so I'm afraid this thing capsizes, tips over, boom, boom, and I go in the water. So I'm a little nervous. So what about you?
Well, I'm glad you bring this up. Kids, you ever had been in a canoe? Yeah, you guys had been, yeah, some of you. So you have to sit still. You cannot just jump around, and you have to sit very calm. And so I had a canoe experience some years ago with my boys and Grandpa B. We went for a canoe trip to several lakes. We had two canoes and one kayak. And so we canoed, had so much fun, and on our way back, there was a big lake we had to pass, and the wind started, and it was blowing, and we were in the middle of this lake, and we were canoeing, but we didn't move forward because the wind and the waves were blowing towards us. But Grandpa B had a great idea. He says, let's move, paddle to the right side, and there is a friend of mine, he has a cabin, he might help us. So we turned to the right, and the wind was blowing us to the shore. It went really easy, and then his friend Bob was there. He helped us, he gave us some snacks, some water, and he had a boat, motorboat, and he pulled us with the canoes to the other side of the lake where we could portage, get to the other one. So he helped us out. So that was a really good thing.
Wow, you got lucky. I hope I don't have all this wind, and it's a safe trip. So I hope it all turns out good. Wasn't in the Bible a story too about wind and waves?
Yes, there was. Jesus was in a boat with his friends. He was asleep, and a big storm came, and they woke him up. And Jesus says, peace, be still. And there was no waves anymore. So guys, when you get afraid and when you're nervous about things or had a bad dream, you talk to your mom or grandma or grandpa or dad, and then you say a prayer together to God and says, peace, be still. Peace, be still. Let's say a prayer. Dear God, thank you for summertime.
Thank you for summertime.
That we can have fun together. And go on trips.
Go on trips.
Please keep us safe.
Please keep us safe.
And when we are afraid, we can pray to Jesus. And Jesus says, be still. Have peace. Peace, be still. And then you guys will have peace. Amen.
Have fun in Sunday school. I heard you do some games today and have some good food. So have fun, okay? See you later, guys. Bye. Bye, you guys.
How long did it take for him to get Florida to here?
Took me a long time. I got on a plane, but it was very busy. Long, long time. Yes.
Bye. I just went with Florida.
Bye. Bye.
All right. Let us pray for the reading of the word. God of grace and glory, prepare our hearts as we listen to your word. Open our hearts and minds and give us a desire to learn from you. May your Holy Spirit guide us into all truth and expand our understanding of your word in a real and living way. Bring nourishment for our souls and refreshment for our spirits as we hear your word this day. We pray this in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Good morning. The reading is Psalm 107. Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his steadfast love endures forever. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so, those he redeemed from trouble and gathered in from the lands. From the east and the west, from the north and the south, some went down to the sea in ships, doing business on the mighty waters. They saw the deeds of the Lord, his wondrous works in the deep. For he commanded and raised the stormy wind, which lifted up the waves of the sea. They mounted up to heaven. They went down to the depths. Their courage melted away in their calamity. They reeled and staggered like drunkards and were at their wit's end. Then they cried to the Lord in their trouble, and he brought them out from their distress. He made the storm be still, and the waves of the sea were hushed. Then they were glad because they had quiet, and he brought them to their desired haven. Let them thank the Lord for his steadfast love, for his wonderful works to humankind. Let them extol him in the congregation of the people and praise him in the assembly of the elders. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
I invite you to stand for our gospel reading. Today it is from Mark, the fourth chapter. When evening had come, Jesus said to his disciples, "Let us go across to the other side and leave the crowd behind." They took him with them in the boat, just as he was. Other boats were with him. A great windstorm arose, and the waves beat into the boat, so that the boat was already being swamped. But he was in the stern, asleep on the cushion. And they woke him up and said to him, "Teacher, do you not care that we are perishing?" He woke up and rebuked the wind and said to the sea, "Peace, be still." And the wind ceased and there was a dead calm. He said to them, "Why are you afraid? Have you still no faith?" And they were filled with great awe and said to one another, "Who then is this, that even the wind and the sea obey him?" The Gospel of the Lord. Congregation, please be seated. Well, you just heard one of my most favorite stories in the Bible, Jesus inviting his friends into a boat and cross from one side to the other. So maybe I use the hand mic. Huh? Kai, should I use the hand mic? Yeah. Going to be less noisy with that mic. So as I said, one of my favorite stories is this story about Jesus inviting his friends in the boat, and it's a story about life change, and it's a story about not just his disciples. It's a story for all of us. I was invited many times to get in a boat, but repeatedly I said, "No, I don't want to go." I ignored the call. For years, I was not sure if I really should go in the boat. And finally, one night, I said, "Okay, I'm ready. I'm jumping in the boat, and I'm doing something that I was scared of." So I did. And this journey changed my life and grew my faith immensely. So today, we are going to talk about what happens when we get into the boat to get from one side to the other and explore opportunities in life to grow our faith. But before we get into the boat with Jesus, I would like to share with you a travel story that I just recently had. Some of you know, I shared with you that I was visiting my mom and brother in Germany with my son, Kai. And so when we got on a plane 3 weeks ago on a Sunday afternoon, evening actually, we got into like 2 hours into the flight when it all of a sudden this big airplane, we were eating food, was going like this. And not only going like this, it went like up and down, bounced, and really, so I thought, uh-oh. And then the captain announced, "Passengers, please be seated. Put your seatbelts on. And flight attendants, sit down immediately, now." And oy, oy, oy. So I looked at Kai. Kai was very calm, and I wasn't as calm. So I quietly said my prayer, "God, please help us that we can see my mom, and it's all going to work out." And then Kai leaned over and pointed to the screen he was looking at, and the screen was some numbers, and I had no idea. It wasn't a movie, and I said, "I saw this airplane and some numbers, 35,000. And he says, "Just wait. In a few moments, we will be at 38,000, and everything's going to be fine. And 3 minutes later, the numbers went up. I thought, oh, good, we are not going down. Up is always good. So we went up exactly to 38,000, and then it was super smooth. So I was grateful for the captain, and I was impressed that Kai knew what the captain was going to do, and we landed safely and had an awesome time in Germany. So we encountered turbulences, and that's happened in life. We all know how that feels once in a while when things get shaky. So for the disciples, all started when Jesus invited them into the boat by saying, let's cross from one side to the other. They went from Capernaum, fishing town, to the other side of the lake. It's called the country of the Gerasenes. After they left shore, it was a quiet evening. Everything was nice. Jesus was tired from preaching and from healing people and from sharing food. And so he rested at the stern of the boat, and the guys, fishermen, were moving this boat from one side to the other. So far, so good, until the wind came up. Not just wind, waves got higher and higher. These guys experienced, first didn't think about too much about it, but then they realized more water comes in than they can bail out. So the disciples looked now anxiously at one another. Fear gleamed in their eyes. It has been suggested that they had the same fear that Noah had when he realized he was in a wooden ark with at least two termites. Well, that's funny, but for the disciples, it wasn't funny. They were not laughing, and they were just saying, all hands on deck, we are sinking. Meanwhile, Jesus was sound asleep, and the question is, do we trust now a Jesus who is maybe asleep in our lives, or maybe we think is absent? Do we trust a sleepy Jesus? The disciples didn't. For the 12, a sleepy Jesus was as good as no Jesus at all. But they trusted him enough to wake him up, to push him on the shoulders and say, Jesus, please get up. Don't you care that we are drowning right now? And Jesus woke up, and now he did something you shouldn't do in a canoe or in a smaller boat when waves is. He stood in the boat. Well, he didn't keel over. He said, peace, be still. And the wind ceased and the waves calmed. They were astounded by his authority and wondered who he was. He who had power over ferocious wind and very high waves, and he made it to the other side alive. The journey from one side of the lake to the other became a life-changing experience for them. The horrific storm taught them to have faith no matter what. They learned that Jesus teaches and heals people, but he also is the Lord of strong winds and high waves. He is the Lord of life in whom they needed to put their trust. For all disciples in the boat and the other boats that were with them were amazed what Jesus did, and their faith were growing. G.K. Chesterton, an English poet and philosopher, said once, one sees great things from the valley, but only small things from the peak. It is the valley and in the storms of our lives that we find God. Think about in your own life when you felt close to God, when your faith grew. Often it is when we are invited into the boat to go from one side to the other. Often these journeys get us out of our comfort zone, get us out of being in control. Fear over the unknown and losing controls are often a factor that holds us back. He might sleep. He might be absent, we think. Now what? If we know there will be a storm, we might not get into the boat. If Jesus would tell us in advance what is on the other side, we would never have gotten into the boat. For the disciples, it became quite a ride. There are many times in life when we encounter storms or challenging situations, and we pray for help and feel our prayers sometimes are not answered in the way we want. In our Man in Action group, we just went through a prayer course, and one of the topics was, what is it when God doesn't answer the prayers in the way how we want it? Or maybe not at all, and we pray and pray, God, heal us, help us. Or we're going through a difficult time in our marriages, or we're going into difficult times at work, and we are having so many things that are changing on us, and we feel God is not there. So the speaker of the course, Pastor Pete Greig, described the situation from his own life when his wife, he was at the time newly married, they had two young children, one morning woke up and her legs didn't move anymore and she had seizures and he was very, very scared and they went to the hospital and the doctor looked at her and did tests and came to him and said, well, I have some not so good news, your wife has a tumor and she needs surgery. So she went under surgery. They prayed a lot and she survived, but she kept on having seizures, epileptic seizures. And of course, he was asking, Guy, why us and why is it so hard? But he kept having faith in God and he realized that God was with them all the way along. Pete and his wife did not give up on God. They kept praying and believing. Pastor Pete shared a story about another pastor, Pastor Samuel Rutherford, who experienced also in his life great pain when sadly he lost his own wife and he was a pastor, lost his ministry, and he was very sad. And he said these profound words, I see that grace grows best in winter. So Pete Greig gave an example in the course. He had a tree and he said, well, we plant a tree sometimes in the springtime, and then there are leaves and there are fruits, and then the summer comes and the dry season comes and the roots didn't go very deep and the tree dries up. But if we plant a tree before the winter season, then the roots go deep and they have enough energy to make it to the next season. So actually, he says, the winter primes the tree, and the trees become stronger and stronger. So he thinks about this has happened in our life. When we have a winter season, when we go through storms, often our roots go deep, our faith becomes stronger. When Jesus invites us to get into the boat, it is always a faith journey to another shore. It is a journey where we grow in faith. In various instances, church has been compared over the centuries as a boat where we come together, where we experience highs and lows, where we support each other and keep our eyes on Jesus. And sometimes we wake him up. So our caring place is a place that is also a boat for many people who are at a specific time in their lives and they need support, they need community. So I want to ask Rosa, who is our leader of the Caring Place, to share a little bit what she experienced and how what is happening now in the Caring Place. So Rosa, thanks for coming up. We're going to share now this mic. So tell us a little bit about how the Caring Place is a boat.
So good morning, everybody. You know, when I think about the boat at the Caring Place and what we do there, I think of it for our participants kind of like a party boat, right? You know, a place where you go to have fun and enjoy, you know, life, right? And so we learn there, we get creative there, we make friends there. It's just a good time. We also mourn there, but we also celebrate. For our participant families, their caregivers, it's more like a refuge. It allows the caregivers space to find peace at home, take a few minutes for themselves, get to their own doctor's appointments, while their family members are partying on the boat.
So I'm wondering, Rosa, about what really a difference it makes in their lives when they experience being a part of this community.
You know, we talked about this, and I feel like it's become a family. You know, we have, between our staff and our volunteers and the participants and the families, there's so much togetherness, right, that we're doing. We're doing life together with them, and but I'm sorry, guys. I get a little emotional thinking about how close we've become. Just last week, we had one of our gentlemen who needed to transition into another community. and the friendships that were formed. We had another participant just saying goodbye, reaches up and gives him this big embrace and just says, I'm sorry, I'm going to miss you, brother. Brother, I mean, they see each other as brother and sister, and it's just a family there.
Yeah, and I shared last night at the Saturday service that one of our staff members, she actually visited him in his new place and checked in with him, and it goes really far. So we talk about boat, and we talk about when we're going through winter times, winter seasons, how our faith and our roots go deep and our faith strengthens. So I wonder, Rosa, since you are part of this awesome ministry, how did this impact it and touch your faith in your life?
I had to think about that one for a little while. Pastor shared the questions with me earlier this week, and the one thing that is really obvious and one word that comes to mind in a respite care is love. There's so much love there. The love that the people have for each other, the love for, the spouses, when they leave their husbands here with us and they go out and they're talking and they have lunch together. And there's the support. We've got a couple of folks who have had some medical needs with our volunteers, and you know, everyone's sending cards, and we called the one gentleman on his birthday, and everybody, you know, on speakerphone, we're wishing him a happy birthday and singing to him. And it's just, there's so much love. I've been in long-term care, and I've taken care of seniors for over 20 years now, and people in long-term care, it's a job, right? But our volunteers, our staff, they're not here for a paycheck. They're here to lead with love and to care with love. And just like Jesus did, right? We're here to love one another, and that's what's happening there.
So you mentioned Jesus. He keeps us inviting to get in the boat. So if someone sits here this morning and says, well, I have a neighbor, or I have a relative, or I have a little bit time, I want to get in this boat. So how can they get in the boat now, in the boat for the caring place, for example?
Yeah, well, I invite you all to invite somebody. If you know someone who has a senior in your family or neighbor that is lonely or needs a break, and they're caring 24 hours a day, 7 days a week for someone, this gives them a little break. We're not a long day. It's Monday, Wednesday, and Thursday, 9:30 to 2:30. They can come and spend time with us. If you need some friendship, we've become friends. I mean, young and old, we're all friends there. If you would like to share, God gives us all talents, right? We all have something in us that we can share with other people. And if you've got the gift of presence and you just want to come and hold someone's hand, if you have a musical talent or an artistic talent that you would like to share with us, come for an hour. If you can't do a whole day, if you can't do an hour, come for half an hour. Say hello. We have one lady who, she has the gift of baking, but she can't eat it all. So she brings some goodies and treats for us every week. We have one member. We took a trip to Disney, my only trip to Disney, last week. And we had a great time. We had crafts. We played Disney Bingo. We had ears, Mickey and Minnie ears. And we even were in front of the castle, as you can see. So lots of fun there. A good time. I invite you all to come and share your gifts with us.
Well, and sometimes you even start dancing. And it is really fun to see our friends getting up from their seat and start dancing and to their favorite music when they were younger and having a good time. And so that creates energy and juices, and they're really excited. So thanks for your awesome work, Rosa, and let's give her a hand for this great leadership. Thank you. So as I said, Jesus continues not just me or Rosa or all of you. You are invited to get a part getting into the boat. For some, it's smaller children's ministry. For others, it is ministry at their work when they share their faith there. We all are invited. And let's be honest, sometimes we say, I don't want to get in there. This is too dangerous, and who knows what might happen. But the promise is when we get in the boat, we are not alone. There is Jesus. There, Jesus sends people to us. And when we experience that, it's really, really powerful. I want to close with a prayer, and Megan gracefully said she would sing it with us. It's from Hillsong United. The prayer is a part of the song, Where My Feet May Fail. And it's beautiful words that summarize what I tried to say. And so listen to the words and pray quietly. Sing with us as Megan leads us now. Thank you, Megan.
Sure. We're going to invite the Sunday school students to come on up here. We've been learning a song pretty regularly, once a month. I think last time we sang at Easter. And so this next song is called Turn, Turn, Turn. You're welcome to sing with us. They're going to be turning their hands around, and we're going to have fun. So you'll notice that some of the words have been changed a little bit. You might think, wait, is that right? But I did change them just slightly, okay? But not in the main part, so... Let's do it a few times. We'll sing the refrain, then I'll sing a verse, and then we'll do the other refrains again. Ready, guys? Okay, let's do it. Ready?
To everything, turn, turn, turn. There is a season, turn.
Thanks for joining us, kids. That was fun.
Good job, guys. Let us continue now with the prayers for the family of God. When I say, Merciful God, please respond with, Receive our prayer. Nature sings your love in the morning and your faithfulness at night. Sustain the holy rhythms of creation, days and seasons, hibernation and activity, phases of the moon and tides of the sea. Let these patterns assure us of your constancy. Merciful God,
receive our prayer.
Deliver your people from their distress, O God. We lift before you all who are sick or struggling. We pray especially for Connie, Anne, Bob, Juliana, Max, Alex, Guy, David, and all those we name silently or aloud. Grant consolation and peace to all who live with chronic, terminal or persistent illness. In times of affliction or hardship, sustain us in faith. Merciful God, receive our prayer. Enfold all travelers with your protection. Bless the comings and goings of this assembly as we travel for leisure or for work. Let all journeys be met with hospitality on the way, and let the community members return to us with celebration. Merciful God, receive our prayer. Receive our prayers, O God, and come quickly to our aid through the power of the Spirit and the love of Jesus Christ. Amen.
It's such a gift to be able to worship in God's creation, to be reminded and maybe be jolted in a new way in seeing things in a different way in our faith when we're outside in the grass and with the cicadas and some of the flowers and the breeze. So let us give back in God's creation all that God has given us.
Face the waves. I don't wanna be afraid. I don't wanna be afraid. I don't wanna fear the storm because I hear it roar. I don't wanna fear the storm. I don't wanna fear the storm. Gonna be afraid, 'cause these waves are only waves. I'm not gonna be afraid. I'm not gonna be afraid. I'm not gonna fear the storm. You are greater than its roar. I'm not gonna fear the storm. I'm not gonna fear at all.
Let faith rise up, oh heart.
Congregation, let us pray. Let us pray together. Jesus, bread of life, you have set this table with your very self and called us to the feast of plenty. Gather what has been sown among us and strengthen us in this meal. Make us be what we receive here, your body, for the life of the world. Amen. Let us prepare our hearts for Holy Communion. The weather's holding out for us. This is the time when we come together to be made new, and we come together to be reminded of your peace. We come together to be in community with all your grace, Lord God, and we just let it be, because we know that when we let it be, you work on us, and you form us anew, and you create us in us something different than what has been before. And so, Lord, we let that be today. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it for all to eat, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this and remember me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood poured out for you." Poured out so that you can have a new life, so that you can start anew, so that today is a new day. It's the beginning of everything good in my name. Do this also and remember me. And let us pray the prayer that our Lord has taught us together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Christ has set the table with more than enough for all. Come. And actually, we're just going to stay. So you have the little, remember how we used to do this. You can take the top layer off and then take the second layer. The blessing of God, who provides for us, feeds us, and journeys with us, be upon you now and forever. Amen.
Okay, are we on our last song?
Oh, okay, I need a second. The pages. Please stand. We're going to sing our last song, My Lighthouse. But these pages are gonna fly away, so give me just a second.
All right, ready?
One.
Go in peace. You are the body of Christ. Thanks be to God. Please join us after for some refreshments and games and just some great time together. Thank you.
You gonna play a song? But it's also about, I feel like the sky is gonna fall. So I think we need to move this stuff quickly.